Hi guys, so I just want to share with you this local development in HubSpot. So if you want to create or design your HubSpot templates locally, then they have a documentation. Actually, this is the page, but check all of the things in here. All the command lines are listed in here. You can also use the HS health to see the other command lines that you can use. But yeah, I just want to document things here to make sure I didn't forget anything, because sometimes I feel more productive documenting stuff. It's more retainable to me when I document stuff versus on just keeping it as is. Okay. So first, we will cover how you can install a boilerplate on HubSpot. We will cover how to install a boilerplate template on our local computer, and then how to install a CMS, HubSpot CMS. So a CMS in HubSpot and boilerplate as well. Then how you can upload your files or boilerplate template from local computer to your HubSpot account. So in this video, I think they only cover this part. Okay, yeah, this part. So. And this, I think, and yeah, I just want to document these things. Feel free to skip it if you are already familiar on cms-cli. So this is the documentation in HubSpot. I'm gonna use Visual Studio as an IDE, and then I already created a folder in here. So now I'm gonna run a CMS, this command. So npm install HubSpot cms-cli. So that will install the HubSpot CMS, and then this one, by the way, is for global. And then this one is, let's say for example you already use HubSpot last year, and then you want last year, then this npm thing can CMS at latest will update the latest version of your HubSpot CMS. But for now, we will use the npm installed HubSpot CLI. By the way, you need to install node.js as well to make it work. So simply go to the node.js download. So you need to install this one first before anything else, okay? And then after that, we will run this command here. So okay, so I'm gonna put that npm install at HubSpot slash cms-cli. So that will install the CMS. So yeah, I'll just pause this for a while, and then I'll get back to you once it is already installed. Okay, so once the installation is already completed, you will see this part, node_modules, and then the package JSON. Now we will authenticate our HubSpot. Now we can also create a manual YML. So they have a tutorial for that, but there's also a command line that you can use that will let the HubSpot do the HubSpot config YML. I mean, the HubSpot will generate that YML for you. So you just need to put this code here. This is for the authentication. You can use hs init or npx hs init. So we will put that there, npx hs init. This is for authentication, by the way. So okay, you will see this when you're ready. The browser will be open to connect your token or your personal, you know, personal token. So let's just press enter there, and then it will connect to your HubSpot account. So if you want to connect it with the other HubSpot account, you just need to click this view accounts, but you need to make sure that it is connected to your right email address. Now I'm going to use my Sandbox BookwormHead account. And by the way, this is free. You don't need to purchase for a premium plan on HubSpot if you are doing development. So let's just select the BookwormHead, and I'm going to click this continue. And then we will copy this code here. Okay. And then copy, and then after that we will paste that code here. So personal access to MS key that will connect your local computer into your HubSpot account. Now, enter a unique name. This is just for reference on your development. So I'm going to just use BookwormHead. And then, okay, after that, we already connect the CMS into our local computer. We can push, we can watch, because we already connected the personal CMS token. Now, what we will do the second step. So the second step is we will install a boilerplate on HubSpot. So we will install a boilerplate template on our local computer, okay? So the command line for that is this one. So npx HubSpot create CMS platform, and what's the name of the project? So I'll just call it BookwormHead, and then let's type in there, and then npx, okay? So this will generate a boilerplate template for you. So as you can see here, there is already another folder called BookwormHead, and this will be your template. So if you click this one, you will see a lot of files in here. And when you go into the source SRC folder, these are the templates, like the boilerplate templates in HubSpot, okay? By the way, this one, you cannot view this these files, this HTML, when you click the server live view, you cannot view that on your local computer if you don't use a another method. There is a tutorial for that. I'm gonna put it on the link description. It is created by other YouTuber. By the way, you can also install an extension. HubSpot has an extension, so if you want to, you know, work on this stuff, they also have an extension here. You can, it's called HubSpot VS Code. So this one, I think I already installed that one. So this one, HubSpot VS Code. So anyway, so we already done the cloning. The next step we can do is how we can upload the files or our boilerplate template from our local computer to our HubSpot account. So how we can do that? There is a command line for that, for pushing. So to push or to upload your HubSpot files, you just need to run this command. It's called npx HubSpot create. No, it's not the right one. This is rather npx hs upload create a name. It's not create a name. So you need to put the name of the project. So BookwormHead, SRC, and BookwormHead. So this one is the folder that will be named to your HubSpot files, and then this one is the name of your local computer. Please correct me if I'm wrong. So I'm gonna put it there here. Now we can push the HubSpot, we can push the files to our HubSpot portal or to our designer manager, because we already done the authentication process. Remember the personal token? So we already connected that one. So if you can see, check the HubSpot config.yml. You'll see that it's already connected to our portal ID and we already authenticated. So we can then start pushing our BookwormHead files or BookwormHead boilerplate to our local computer, to our HubSpot portal. So let's run this. So npx hs upload BookwormHead. So I'm gonna process that one. And then, yeah, it is already uploading. Now, once we already finished this one, it will be reflected to our HubSpot account, I believe. So I'm gonna log into my HubSpot account under my personal sandbox. And then I go to the designer and then designing tools, and okay, you'll see this one. So as you can see, the boilerplate called BookwormHead is already transferred to our HubSpot portal. So I hope this has been helpful. I also have a part two series of that on how you can update or push your changes to your from your local computer to your HubSpot account, and we will discuss probably the watch thing on HubSpot, how you can remove, how you can overwrite your files from your local computer to your HubSpot designer manager. That will be covered in the part two series. Also, if you want to receive tricks and tips about HubSpot and you want to download a customized template that I personally created, then check out my link description below to receive an update. Thanks, guys. Have a great day.